Well, so I did the wrong thing again and bought me a piece of gear I don't really need. But I got a good deal on it, so might as well unbox it. You can see the big box it came in. It was packed with this stuff. I like this much better than bubble wrap because it's easier to break down and get rid of. But anyway, I bought me a Dean, what are they, a Backwoods 6 banjo. I think they're guitar banjos. What do they call them? Banjitars. Banjitars or Gitanjos. I just like six string banjo. What's curious about this, these usually go a little north of $350. It was an open box deal from Musiciansfriend. Condition level 4, which means it needs repair to be played. So I got it, I think $154, $155. So let's see what we got here. Yep, it's been opened. You can see the crappy retape job. Ah, not too bad. I don't see anything glaringly wrong with it yet. Let's see here. Got a Remo head. Feels pretty tight. It's all right. There are 4 resonator screws are on it. The arm rest is on it. I don't see any nicks. Side of the frets. Wow, they're sharp. Pretty sharp frets. What would be horrible is if the headstock was broke. And it's not. Made in China. Looks like it's got some copy Grovers on it, but they're not labeled Grover anywhere. I don't see anything glaringly wrong with it, except it doesn't have the bridge on it. So, is that in the box? Oh, yes. Here's the bag of accessories. Cool. What do we got in here? Here's the bridge. Looks like a, all right, cheapo little simple bridge. Cool. Then we got Allen wrench, probably for the truss rod neck. Truss rod in the neck, I guess. And what would this be? Yeah, multi-tool. So, we'll see. I wonder if that's how you tighten the head down with it. Ah! Inspection sticker. 5323 by James G. Huh. So, I don't see anything broke with it. Crappy styrofoam, silica gel, don't eat that unless you want to dry yourself out and probably die from some sort of poisoning. Yeah, so, oh, now I'm noticing that string was pinched to the side. It is missing the low E string. If that's it, then I am pleased. I'm a pleased as a possum in a breeze way. Man, it doesn't look bad at all. Why did I buy a banjo? Well, because they record awesome. I can't play it. I mean, I can plunk around. I'm an intermediate guitar player, and if I take my time recording and practicing, I can make relatively decent stuff, but definitely not a pro. So, I'm going to try setting this thing up and take you along with me. Maybe we'll discover what's wrong with it. But for right now, it just looks like it's missing a the low E string. What the heck? Awesome. Well, so I don't know anything about banjos, but what I'll do is just set this up as a guitar and try to take some as-found measurements before I do any setup work on it. So, first thing we'll do is check the neck for straightness. While the strings are loose, it's got back bow in it, a lot of back bows. There's probably 30,000ths gap here, and it doesn't get flush till about here. Then it's flush up to about here, and then it starts falling away again. Doesn't have back bow, it's got front bow. It's like this. But I'm not gonna adjust that yet until I get all the strings on. At least the neck is square this way. What do they say scale length is? 25 and a half. Let's make sure that's correct. So I'm gonna measure from the nut, the front of the nut, to the front of the 12th fret. And I got 12 and 3 quarters on the money. So that is 25 and a half. So we're gonna set the bridge in. So we'll set the strings in the bridge. Okay. And then we'll move it to where it should be 25 and a half. Yeah, that's making a racket. I should have got a tape measure that has a lock on it. 25 and a half to the front of the bridge. Yep. So is that straight? Yep, good enough for government work. Wow, it's resonating. Hello. The canyon. So I'm gonna set the tail piece to roughly, I don't know, horizontal, and then we'll tune her up. Okay, let me fast forward through this. So, the more I tune the thing up, the more it's pushing the bridge down on the head. So there's not enough tension on the head. So let's tension the head down a little bit. And to do that, we gotta take the resonator off. Well, so I Google-ated it. I thought, should I take the string tension off before I set the head? And most sites say no, leave the strings on it and try to tune the head to G sharp. But you can see, I put this chopstick on just to give you a straight edge. See how low the bridge is sinking? Let's rotate that and make sure I don't got a warp stick. Nope, it's probably sinking in a quarter inch. So let's take the resonator off the back so we can tighten the head. And to do that, I went and got a screwdriver that adequately fits the resonator bolts. Yeah, I'm getting excited. This thing is ringy, ringy, ringy. The obnoxiousness of a banjo. Yeah, not too bad. We'll drop the parts. That feels pretty decent. Pretty substantial, thick metal. I think this is made out of NATO wood. I can't spell it, so I probably can't say it right either. Okay, yep. Yeah, not too bad. Here's the... Oh, this was loose. Where did that go? There, I bet. And they say go, I don't know, a quarter of a turn. Let's go eighth. There. Quarter of a turn, quarter of a turn, quarter of a turn. That was really loose. Squirrels chasing each other. Silly squirrels. But it did bring it up probably an eighth of an inch. So we'll go an eighth of a turn. Say tune to G sharp. It's probably a G. Let's go another half. Another eighth of a turn. Another quarter. Well, I couldn't leave well enough alone. I got the head tight. It's probably tuned to A instead of G sharp, but it feels good to me, so I'm gonna leave it there. But I went to go adjust the coordinator rod and I didn't understand how it worked. Well, there's only one bolt that holds the neck on. So this rod goes through the shell into the neck, and then this screw threads through the end of that rod to stop the rod from spinning. And then this turnbuckle threads on here, and it's got straight threads, but this is reverse threads. So as you tighten it, it'll warp the shell. So the action was so high, I wanted to make sure I wouldn't get this banjo way out of whack. So I got the head tightened really even just by feel. And then I measured, look, make sure that the head shell is round. So I did, and it's exactly 11 inches from end ring to end ring all the way around. So now I'm gonna try to put this back together and give myself the maximum amount of adjustment on this turnbuckle. Wish me luck. I got this rod in, and this screw right here is holding it in, but you can see how floppy that is, but it's not gonna move now. So this is tight, tight. Yep, you can tell it's Chinese built. Well, I got the neck bolted back on, and it appears the way you adjust the coordinator rod is with this turnbuckle. So I gave myself as much adjustment slack as I could, but what's goofy is look where the nut comes out. I don't know if you can see that. It's right in front of the tail piece adjustment. So I got this rod pulled as far forward as I can to give me adjustment of the tail piece. And then I got to thinking, the head is so tight it's tuned to A and the bridge is still sinking. What's going on? So I went and got my calipers and measured all the string gauges. The E string wasn't missing. It was the high unwound B. So this thing came with a 9, which is normal for a 9 set, but the next string should be 11. It's not, it's a 16. So it's got 9, 16, 24, 30, and 40 on it. And the E wasn't in. Well, these four strings all gotta shift down. So the A becomes the E, the D becomes the A, the G becomes the D, and then luckily I keep my old strings. We'll get the B string out of here. So I'm going through and re-stringing it, and then we'll regroup. What a nightmare. Well, you can see it's dark outside, so I've been messing with this for, I know, a couple hours. Anyway, I got the resonator, or the coordinator rod, really tight. I got the action down to an eighth of an inch, which is what Deering banjos usually say is good. So yeah, that's not bad. The neck, once the string tension was on, was pretty dead tight. So I set it up about, I don't know, 10 thousandths, maybe a little bit more. And then intonated the bridge. You can tell it's like this little bit, which means that's good. So this is what it sounds like without the resonator on it. Yeah, you see better than that, it's gonna be loud.
company. Yes, did you see Norfolk? After you meet her family.
I don't know what to play. I'm gonna have to learn some riffs. How about? Fun cover. Anyway, I'm gonna finish putting it back together. I'm gonna let it settle down for a while because I've loosened and tightened the head like four times. I think I got the tension pretty even, but these aren't very good banjos. For $150, that was, you know, I'm glad I bought it for that, but would I give $360 for it? You know, banjo guitars are pretty rare, so they're expensive, and I think you're either buying junk or buying something that's way too nice. And I don't know, man. If you have any thoughts, feel free to post them. Talk to you later.